Hello everyone, I am Vikram P. Maduri here. Welcome to GH Softech. In this session, we are going to discuss the roles and responsibilities of an SAP S4 HANA consultant. And in this, we'll be discussing generic kind of roles and responsibilities which are expected from most of the consultants, like even if they are from a functional background, a technical background, or even from the administration background. As we all know, whether we are working on any of the modules in SAP, in general, we'll have four different types of projects, wherein we have the implementation project, support or maintenance project, and migration or upgradation project, rollout project. So in this, most of the projects which are right now running on SAP S4 HANA are migration projects, in which the client would be most probably moving from ECC server to the S4 HANA server. The entire setup would be moved from ECC to the S4 HANA. Now, in this, what the client would be expecting, what are the roles and responsibilities that an SAP S4 HANA consultant should have? Before discussing that, what the client would be normally expecting is the client would be expecting at least one full life cycle project on SAP S4 HANA. So what I'm trying to tell you here is, if you say that you have worked on SAP S4 HANA, then they'll be expecting one full life cycle project. They prefer to have at least one full life cycle project on implementation experience on SAP ECC server. And then we have a preference of people who have worked on at least one migration project, that is moving the entire system from ECC to S4 HANA. Now, in general, if you are having around 3 to 6 years of experience, the roles and responsibilities would be generally understanding the business process. We need to understand the entire overview of the business process, requirement gathering, how to gather the requirement and all these things. You should be knowing that this is one very important role, and analysis of the requirements, building functional specifications, or if you are a technical guy, technical specification, and configuration experience if you are a functional person, or if you are from the ABAP point of view technical, so you should be good in development. And if you are from a basis background, so then you will be looking out for SAP S4 HANA administration role. For that, you need to have a good configuration skills on administration part. You need to have a thorough knowledge and transport management and preparation of UTP and preparation of UAT. User acceptance, unit test plan and user acceptance test. Now, in SAP S4 HANA, if you are in the senior level in the sense 6 to 12 years experience, guys, in that case, you should be in a position to help the clients understand best practices so they can do more with SAP, and they should be able to spot strategies, risks and options, and then recommend approaches that sidestep problems and help clients meet their needs. Lead and coach and advise project staff in addition to managing their performance depending on the project. Give clients option for designs using prototypes. Set up and test the SAP system. Understand and apply SAP technologies or methodologies. Work with clients and stakeholders to make sure they get where they want to go. And use your business smarts to kickstart the transformation programs, whether domain or platform led. Now, the must-have skills for every consultant who is working on SAP S4 HANA would be a very good thorough understanding of SAP HANA platform, the differences between SAP ECC and the SAP S4 HANA, with which we will know what are the advanced features that we have in SAP S4 HANA. And going forward, we are going to discuss that one as well. And Fiori application, you should be good in using the Fiori application, and then understand the activate methodology, which is the alternate for SAP methodology, which we used to use in ECC. Should have SQL basics, ABAP basics, and also debugging. And I can say that this is not a mandatory skill if you are from administration perspective, but it is always preferred to have SQL basics. But it is mandatory for us to have the clear understanding of HANA architecture and HANA administration as well. Now, theoretical knowledge, you should have theoretical knowledge on HANA perspectives, HANA Studio, and SAP S4 HANA architecture, SAP S4 HANA finance, universal general concept. That's universal general concept is something which you, it's good to know that. And it's mandatory for us to understand OLTP and OLAP differences, row storage and column storage differences, and how it it influences the entire process. And activate in SAP methodology, anyways, we have discussed that. That it is mandatory. Now, in this, like, we have every one of us, if you are moving to SAP S4 HANA platform, most of the basics are given in HA100 book. It's basically a certification book. And you know, if at all, if you, I mean, like, every one of us have to go through that, because most of the basics that we are supposed to learn as an SAP consultant, SAP S4 HANA consultant, are there in the HA100 book. And for that, if at all, if you don't have that book, then you can subscribe to our channel and click on the bell icon. After doing the after subscribing and clicking on the bell icon, send an email to sapeducation@gmail.com from the same email ID from which you have subscribed, and we are going to send you the book from the HA100 book. That would be a PDF book which you can go through that, and that's very important for you as an SAP S4 HANA consultant. Now, the SAP S4 HANA consists of four main components. Let's say you were a functional consultant or a technical consultant. Like you might be a SAP FICO consultant, or you might be a SAP ABAP consultant, or you might be an SAP basis consultant. Now, in this, we were expected technical skills only in that specific area. But when it comes to SAP S4 HANA, we are expected out of box as well. So what are the things that we are expected out? What are the roles and responsibilities that you should be performing as a SAP S4 HANA consultant is what we are discussing here. The functional or core component, and if you are a technical guy, the technical component. Then the presentation or user experience UX component, the reporting or the analytics component, and the app component. So these are the things that you are supposed to know. So the functional core component is like SAP provides the various finance capabilities and enhancements as a part of the functional core component. You need to be on at least SAP NetWeaver 7.4 or SAP ERP, the ECC, ERP Central Component ECC 6.0 enhancement package 7, and SAP HANA version 1.0 to be able to consider a migration or upgrade to S4 HANA. So if at all if you want to move to S4 HANA, these are the prerequisites. And a migration to SAP S4 HANA from EC 6.0 is a functional upgrade that involves the migration of transactional tables. And the presentation user experience component. So this SAP Fiori based GUI component helps you interact with the core component through the user-friendly Fiori screens, and it requires SAP NetWeaver 7.4 and the SAP Gateway versions 2.0. Note that this is an optional component, and you can continue with your existing SAP GUI or SAP NetWeaver business client as your user interface also. But going forward, we will be using Fiori app as the, you know, the UI, user experience. So you should be aware of that. And the reporting analytics, this component enables real-time reporting analytics using pre-packaged HANA live views. So this is extremely important for us to know this as an SAP S4 HANA consultant. And then we have the prerequisites for installation are SAP HANA Live 1.0 for SAP ERP and SAP HANA 2. This too is an optional component. So then we have the app component. This component is a collection of analytical applications in the financial suite for key financial decisions and decision makers in an enterprise. So additionally, you know, these are the, in most of the requirements, you would be expected to know these topics additionally. The enterprise architecture frameworks, different types of frameworks that we have. SAP Activate methodology, which we already discussed that it's mandatory for us, and HANA development. The HANA development is optional. If you have it, it's good. BI reporting is also optional. BI BO reporting, actually we do the reporting on business objects platform. And ABAP coding. Other than BO reporting, we also have Lumira, which was recently inculcated into the reporting of SAP reporting. So we have ABAP coding, it's good to have. Debugging also is good to have when you are a functional consultant or a technical consultant as well. And for Fiori application also, you should be good in that. So in fact, like having all these skills, what are the additional things that you need to have to get an offer or to get a changeover? So if at all, if you're looking for a change in SAP, or if you're looking out for a job in SAP, then it's mandatory for us to have the business process knowledge, extremely good knowledge on the business process. You should have a good education. But if at all, if you have domain experience, then if at all, if you the domain experience would overrule the educational factor. So the domain is more important than the educational background. For example, even if you are having less percentage in your educational background, it does not make a difference when you have a good amount of domain experience. For example, if at all, if you are looking out for SAP S4 HANA finance job, then you should be having, if you have a finance experience, the domain core finance experience, I'm not talking about the SAP experience, core experience, then it will be good. Okay, so good configuration skills, you should have good configuration skills, obviously. Or if you are a technical guy, you know, you should have a good coding skills. And if you are an administration guy, you should have a good real-time exposure to all the options that we have to perform on the server. So you should be a good team player. You should have communication skills. The communication skills should be excellent. You should be able to understand the language that the interviewer speaks to you, and you should be able to communicate to them in an equally ace way. That's what in the communication skills they expect out of you. And understanding business requirements, reading ability, and quality documentation and sharing knowledge. These are the most important qualities that they'll be looking out for a new consultant in SAP S4 HANA platform. And do subscribe to our channel, like the videos, share it with your friends, and do comment and let me know what exactly you would be looking out for in the next coming videos. And also you can give me some suggestions for improvements. I'll definitely go through them and try to inculcate those things. And our channel would be youtube.com/jsoftech. And if at all, if you are looking out for any real-time trainings on SAP, then you can contact us at info@jsoftech.com. Thank you. Have a great day.